TikTok's CEO grilled at a congressional hearing and an interesting lawsuit. This is A Week in Security by ESET. Keep listening to find out more. Controversy surrounding TikTok continues, with their CEO appearing before the US Congress to explain the app's data security and privacy practices. After 5 hours of testimony, I'm not actually sure that we know any more, but here are some of the highlights. The politicians accused the platform of lying about ties to the Chinese government and stated that China's national security law compels companies to share information with the government. Now, the CEO combated this and stated they've never been asked and have never shared. And as far as I understand it, and bear in mind I'm not a lawyer, this only applies to data relevant to the country's national security. But, of course, anything could be deemed a security risk. During the hearings, the CEO explained that American data is stored on American soil, by an American company and overseen by American personnel. Now, this refers to the deal that TikTok have with Oracle, a US-based company they partner with to store all US user data. The claim from TikTok is this data is effectively behind a firewall, or will be once this $1.5 billion project completes. The deal with Oracle dates back to the first time TikTok were in the limelight of the US government, when the Trump administration threatened to ban the app, with much the same concerns that we're actually seeing now. The hearing also discussed the issue of the app's addictive nature on young people. These are concerns that any parent over the last 20 years will understand. This is not just TikTok. Earlier this week, in fact, San Mateo School Board, a school board based in Silicon Valley, filed a federal lawsuit to hold social media companies accountable for the impact the school district is seeing on students. The suit mentions not only TikTok, but also Snapchat and YouTube. They want companies to help pay the cost involved in supporting students due to activity on these platforms. Somehow, I think though it would be better to stop the activity as opposed to have the cash to manage it, post it happening. But hell, that's just my view. Now, my colleagues at We Live Security have published a blog on the issue of privacy and data collection by TikTok. I recommend checking it out. So head over to welivesecurity.com, stay safe, stay healthy, and be sure to catch our next video.